So, keep your knees apart. Relax the toes. From here, just stretching your palm, stretching your wrist joint just a little. Left palm up, left palm down. Right up, right down. And keep switching. Left up, left down. So 10, 9, 8, 7. Do your best to keep your arms straight. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one more time, and 1. Then from here, relax, sit back here, keep your arms straight, all right? High, high, oh, and lower your body down. Inhale and exhale, slowly. Ah!
เมื่อกี้ปิดไป
อันนะมองไปเสียงค่ะแบบหนึ่งน้องเขาปิดเสียงนี้
มันคืออย่างวะ
ฮะ
มันคือ
มันอาจจะเป็นตรงประมาณตรงคอนเนคชั่นอ่ะโอเค so from here let's start we call this one the puppy pose alright usually the child pose we go all the way down with our hip totally relaxedBut because today we want to let go all the tension from the neck, from the shoulder, keep your hands at the corner of your mat. The hips still square and exhale, you try to lower your chin down close to the floor. Back up again, take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale now, not only the chin, try to also pressing the chest down close to the floor.Inhale up. Now, not only the chin and the chest. Think about this time, try to press chin, chest, and your both armpits as close to the floor. Still square your hip, which means your hip and your knee still making the 90 degree. You might try to squeezing at your shoulder blades.Each and every breath, pressing your armpits closer and closer to the floor. With the chest opening, all we need to do here, let go. Let go all the tension from your neck, from your shoulders, from your chest, from your upper back, all the way down to the floor.Let go those tension that no longer deserve us. It's true, every energy is good, but some energy is supposed to be within us. Some energy is supposed to be purified first before it flow back to ourselves. Slowly from here, lift your body up. Take a deep breath and sit back, relax in child pose. So we call this one the embryo pose. So keep your hands by your side, turn your palm facing up. And totally relax your forehead on the floor and letting go all your entire body weight down to the ground. Inhale slowly. Exhale slowly.Inhale to your nose, and you might sigh out to your mouth. One more deep breath, inhale, exhale. Then slowly from here, keep your palms down back to all four, then we're gonna perform the downward facing dog.Tuck your toe, lift the knee up, do your best to keep your legs straight and try to lift the hip up high. So stick your butt up toward to the sky. Make sure that you don't sink your chest down. So try to lift your chest, your ribcage up and look to the space between your both feet. If possible, try to press the heels as close or close to the floor. If your knees bend, I prefer you to keep the other leg straight. And you might just keep swishing, that we call the walking dog. So 10, 9, 8, 7, looking back, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now keep your feet close to each other. Let's start on your left leg first. Inhale, left leg up, keep your left knee bent and open the hip. Circle the left leg out. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Reverse, reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then slowly from here, place your left foot between your hands. And keep your right leg straight. Lift your body up. So if you remember, you're going to rest your arms up. Keep your arms close to your ears. Try to squeeze in the arms closer to the ears. If I go to put my hands between your arm and your ear, I should make it because there is no space. Hold on here. 5, 4, back leg straight. 3, 2, and 1. Keep your palms down. Step your left leg back. And give me the walking dog once again. Still lift the chest up high. Stick your butt up toward to the sky. Hold on here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Right leg up. Lift your right leg up. Bend your right knee and opening the hip. 5, 4, 3, 2, and reverse, reverse. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then slowly from here, place your right foot between your hands and keep your back leg straight. Raise your arms up, squeezing the arms close to the ears. Your back flat, standing long and tall here. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. More deep breath. Inhale and exhale. So keep your palms down and step your right leg back. Back to downward facing dog. Keep your feet slightly apart. Lift the hip up high and make sure you try to lift your chest up, lift your rib cage up. Look to the back of the mat. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. More deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Now inhale, lean forward to the plank. Keep your legs strong. Keep your shoulders stay before your arms. Exhale. If you're able to do chaturanga, do so. If not, go all the way down. Rest your toe. Option 1. Inhale, cobra pose. Shoulder away from the ear. Squeezing at your butt cheek. Or option 2. Try to lift yourself up high. Direct to upward facing dog. Just make sure that you keep your shoulder away from the ears and squeezing at your butt cheeks. Tap your toes and exhale. Lift your body up to downward facing dog. Left leg up first. Inhale. And now exhale. Left foot placed between the hands. So with the chest opening here, keep your hands behind your back. First, lift your arms away from your back. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, try to lift your arm further away from the back. Further away and away. And slowly from here, the humble warrior. Back leg straight, front knee bend 90 degree, and lower your body down. Try to lower your forehead close to your front foot. And look back to your back foot. Squeezing at your shoulder blade still. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. More deep breath here. Inhale and exhale. Release slowly. Just have a look. Keep your front hand below the front thigh. Keep your back hand behind. If possible, you grab your back wrist joint here. Keep that arm straight. This is the option one. Option two, you try to open your chest and look over that shoulder. So right now, I look over my right shoulder. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release slowly. So either you stay like this and rest the left hand up, or try the other one. Keep your front knee bent 90 degree. Relax the back knee. And then this time, try to keep the opposite hand. So keep that hand below. Keep the other hand behind. And if possible, try to grab your hand. If not, doesn't matter. All right, so if you can grab, try. Oh, and from here, tuck your back toe and try to keep the back knee up. Open your chest. Either you look straight or you try to look back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Take a deep breath and keep your palms down. Of course, we still have the other side to go, back to downward facing dog, and you might just keep walking dog for few times. Take a deep breath. Inhale to your nose. Exhale, sigh out to your mouth. And now we're gonna try to do on the other side. Right leg up, inhale. And exhale. Right foot plants between your hands. Keep your back leg straight. So, number one, interlock your finger behind your back and try to squeeze your arms away and away from the back. Keep your back leg straight. Hold on here. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Humble warrior. So front knee bend 90 degree. Keep your back leg straight and try to lower your forehead close to your front foot. Look to your back foot. Hold on here. Still keep squeezing your shoulder blades. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, keep your right hand below the right thigh, left hand behind the back. Grab your left wrist joint with your right hand, open your chest, and try to look over your left shoulder. Try to look over your upper shoulder here. 5, 4, 3, 2. One more deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Release slowly. Whether you do the option one or try to do the option two. So with the option two, twist your body towards to the other side. Use the opposite hand and twist. Or use that hand cross below and keep the other hand back. If you can grab, do so. If not, it doesn't matter. All right, you have this option, you have this option, you have even this option. So go for the option that suits you the most. Just tell you the truth, This option is really also challenge me. Where's my hand? Where's my hand? Ah, try one more time, Watson. Facing down. Take a deep breath. Inhale to your nose. Exhale, sigh out. Two more deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale. And now, lying all the way down to the front of your belly here. Inhale. And exhale slowly. Relax your hand, turn the toe out, and totally relax your face, your chest. So we call this one the crocodile pose. And allow your body to be completely relaxed without squeezing. Just relax. And let go for the neck chest opening. You keep your feet together, all right? Relax the toe. Keep your hands close to your chest. So keep your thumb close to your nipple, shoulders away from your ears. Inhale here. Lift your chin, your chest up, squeezing at your butt cheek, at your thigh. Weight go to your soft belly. Inhale. Now lift yourself up just a little higher. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Keep in mind, every time you lift yourself up, try to opening your chest more. Feel the stretching at the front of your body, squeezing at your butt cheek. Work very less at your back. And lower yourself all the way down. So, give me one more time. Again, repeat, palms close to your chest, your thumb close to the nipple, keep your elbows squeezing close to your body. Inhale, lift yourself just a little up, exhale. Inhale, exhale. So bear in mind, every time you lift yourself up, working more from your butt cheeks, feel the stretching at the front of your body. Less work out, especially at your back muscles. Up, up, up. And lower yourself all the way down. And now, interlock your finger behind your back, squeezing your arms up and away from your back, squeezing at your shoulder blades. Inhale and exhale. Lift your chin, your chest up. Weight go to your soft belly. Your arm not here. Your arms up and away from your back, from your buttock. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release slowly, hand close to your chest. Tuck your toe, lift your body up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Stay here for 5 deep breaths. Inhale to your nose, sigh out to your mouth. And now let's challenge yourself. Go all the way down. Once again, this time bend at your knees and grab outside of your foot. Option one, you lift only your chin, your chest up. Weight go to your soft belly. Or option two, lift only your thighs up, your chin, your chest on the floor. Or option three, chin chest up, thighs up. Try to keep your both arms straight, direct to the bow pose. Then round snap, so opening the chest. At the same time, lift your leg up high, squeezing more from your butt cheeks, hey? Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. So, for the people who are practicing Ashtanga Yoga, one thing that if you have female menstruation, you got a period, so any kind of the back bending that you are on stomach, not really recommend, including if you are pregnant as well. So many posture that you need to lie on your stomach, pregnancy, people who got a period, not recommend. All right, and relax in child pose. Inhale and exhale slowly. And get ready for the next chest and shoulder opening. So the next one, I want to step your left foot forward, keep your right leg back. Observe from the video, your front knee be aligned with your ankle joint. At the same time, sink your back leg down. So you should feel the stretching at your opposite hip flexor. Here, bend 90 degrees. Shoulder back and down. Inhale, raise your arms up. Keep your arm close to your ear. Which leg forward, you're gonna side bending to that side. However, it's have two keywords here. Up and side bending, not side bending immediately, okay? So up and side bending. Up and side bending. Up and side bending. Arm close to the ear still, there is no space. Face up, look up, hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then back to the center. So same with the other leg. So you step now your right foot forward, keep your back leg totally relaxed. Your left leg, feel the stretching at your left hip flexor. Your right knee be aligned with your right ankle joint. Again here, keep your arms up over the head. So make sure we have two keywords here. Up and side bending, not side bending immediately. So up, squeezing and side bending. Up and side bending. Up and side bending. Up and side bending, hold on, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. More deep breath, inhale and exhale. Then relax. So get ready for the neck chest opening, so the camel pose. With the full camel pose, you need to really take care, because sometimes if people got the back pain, do only the half camel pose. So first, tuck your toe, keep your knee be aligned with your hip. Actually closer is getting more challenge, so keep it apart first. Then right hand at your right hip, and slowly from here try to push your hip forward. Relax your neck or support your head with the other hand. Face up, look up. So make sure you keep your right arm straight, opening your chest here, support the head with the other hand. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then relax and sit back. We do the same on the other side. So first, make sure that you keep your knees slightly apart. Keep now your left hand on your left heel. Push your hip forward. Option one here. If you have any neck pain, support at your neck. If you have any back pain, support at your lower back. Either way, so always listen to your body, all right? Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and one. Then relax and sit back. So the technique before we go to the full camel pose, you start from the half camel pose here. Inhale and exhale. So you switch and do it on the other side. Inhale and exhale. Five. Inhale and exhale. So if you start to feel any back pain, slow down or not do it at all right? Inhale and exhale. We have so many ways to opening the chest, stretching the shoulder. If this one is not one of your options, just only have a look. One more time. Inhale and exhale. For the people who are able to do the full camel pose, keep your hands on the heel, push your hip forward, relax your neck, keep your eyes closed. Option one, tuck the toe. Option two, rest the toe. Option three, try to keep your knees close to each other and push your hip forward. Hold on here, chest open, squeezing at your shoulder blades. Five, four, three, two. Take a deep breath. Either you tuck your toe first, support, and relax. So the way to relax, have a look. Keep your forehead touching at your knee. Keep crown of the head touching at the floor. Keep your hand holding at the heel. So it's gonna be like this. Forehead close to the knee, crown of the head on the floor, and start to lift the hip slightly up. Feel the stretching at the back of your neck and your upper back. Do as much as you feel comfortable or totally relaxed in the embryo pose. In any position, let go. Let go. Let your exhaling to be slower. Let your exhaling to be deeper. And let your breathing to be smoother. And relax. All right, so let's try to do one more thing, another chest opening that we call the wheel pose. The wheel pose is can be start from the floor, or I'm gonna do the other option as well, so by standing. But first of all, you're lying on the floor. So hug the knees close to the chest and rock yourself side to side. Let's do some gentle massage on your lower back. So always have an option, just one condition, listen to your body. Option one, you might just do only the bridge pose. So try to keep the heels close to your buttock. If you're able to let the tip of your finger touch it, that is perfect. Too far, you might hurt more at your hamstring, hey? So bring it closer here. Take a deep breath, inhale. Exhale, spinal imprint, inhale again. Now exhale, lift the hip up high. Weight go to your shoulders slightly, but also the weight should go to the heel. If possible, interlock your finger below your back and try to lay on your shoulder. Think about chest to shin, not chin to chest. Chest to shin, chest to shin. This is the chest opening one, all right? If you have any back pain, support with your hands or totally relax. Option two, instead of the bridge pose, you might try to do the wheel pose. So with the wheel pose, you see that I keep my feet already apart from beginning. Foot, knee, hip be aligned. Keep your hands, your palm turned upside down. Step one, lift crown of the head touching to the floor first. And step two, adjust your hand. Step three, pushing yourself up. Try to keep the weight to your foot, especially at the heel. If possible, try to keep your leg as straight as you can. Try to put from the chest, because today is about chest opening. Awesome. This is not my option. What about I try to keep the heels off? Maybe this one is my relief some tension, but I prefer this one. Or just back to the bridge, the glute bridge. All right. But once you're done, make sure that hug the knees close to the chest. In some case, some people able to do the wheel pose from the standing, but make sure don't try to do the standing one without someone helping you. Anything is all about listen to your body. I give you the easiest option. Keep your hand behind your hip here. Inhale, open your chest, push your hip forward. You might just keep your knees slightly bent, look up, and leaning forward, feel the stretching at your hamstring, all right? And every time that you try to warm it up here, you start to walk your hand a little closer to your knee and forward bending. Inhale, walk the hand even lower than the knee. And exhale. If you have very severe back pain, just only observe. Appreciate by only watching. Try not to attempt to do, because it's good to do exercise, but it's better to do exercise correctly without creating any pain. There is a good pain and a bad pain, by the way. The good pain is just when you're stretching and you feel the slight tension. But once you've done the stretching, those pain is gone. That should be a good pain. The bad pain is whether I do exercise or not. I move, I feel pain. I lying down, I feel pain. I walk, I feel pain. That probably not so good pain. So sometimes the yoga not able to solve all the problem. Visit the doctor, visit the physiotherapist might be the better option, hey? So this is, it's just only warming up. If you're able to do back and forward, I've been practicing yoga for a little while. One thing that I know, my back is strong. My leg is strong, and I keep practicing this under the supervision. So you might just have a look or try with someone, support your back, okay? Inhale and exhale. Inhale and woohoo! Exhale. All right, and relax. So, last stretching that totally recommend everyone to do, not only to relieve the pain from the shoulder, from the neck, but you're gonna feel good after you done this one. So lying down on your back. First, stretch your arms forward, like you try to walk forward. You know that from the scene of the movie when you get shot, help me, help me, something like that. Anyway, so from here, you can start with any hand, but you have to do both sides, hey? You try to keep first, maybe the right hand cross to the left side, and then cross the left hand to the right side. Even though I do so many stretching, I might not feel at my shoulder, but I bet you this one you're gonna feel really, really good on your shoulder. Hard to talk. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, two, one, more deep breath, inhale, exhale, and again, walk your hand forward, back to the shooting scene, help me, help me. So keep walking your hand forward, this time cross the other hand to the other side first. Go as far as you can, and now walk the other hand to the opposite side. Oh, this side a little bit challenging. Yep, and feel that you very much open your chest. Oh, feel the stretch in your upper back. It's really hard to talk, by the way. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then release slowly. And lift yourself back up. Cool. Let's end with the face cow pose. So another way to stretching the shoulders, all right? First of all, you keep your right foot close to your left buttock. And then you keep your left foot at the other side. So check from the video that you try to keep your knees stacked on the top of each other, okay? Mainly now you should feel some stretching at the side of your left leg. And from here, left knee on the top, you're gonna try to cross your right elbow to the top. Circle from one side to the other side. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take a deep breath, lift the elbow slightly up, and once you exhale, slowly lower, lower, lower your body down. If you can, rest your forearm on the floor, do so. What happened is some people try to go all the way down and you can feel that your butt is slightly off. I prefer your elbows to be off the floor like this, okay? Take a deep breath and hold on. Some people who didn't feel much, I recommend instead you go straight down, try to move your body to a little bit to the left side and lower your forearm down. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then come up slowly. Didn't go anywhere yet because we didn't love ourselves yet today. So show the love to yourself. Oh, try to hug yourself. Nod your head. Side to side. 5, 4, 3. I love you. Awesome. I love you. Don't forget to show the love to yourself. Oh. And we're gonna do on the other side. So switch. Keep your right knee this time on the top. So start from left foot close to your right buttock. And then cross your right foot to the other side. Basically, keep your knees stacked on top of each other. Now, right knee on the top is gonna be left elbow on the top. If you're not able to cross your hand like this, you're like, oh, awesome, I can do only this much. Awesome, I can do only this much. Either way, that's fine, okay? And again, rotate your shoulder from one side. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, raise your arms up a little bit, and exhale, slowly round at your back and start to rest your forearm down as close to the floor as possible. You want to feel the deeper stretching, turn your elbow slightly to the right side. Hold on for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, more deep breath, inhale and exhale. Come up very slowly and of course show the love to yourself. Hug yourself. Stay here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And release slowly and back to sit in the leg cross position. Usually that with the full meditation pose, it's gonna be left on the top of the right and right on the top of the left. It doesn't matter if you're not able to do this one. Just relax and go for the half happy pose or just only the leg cross position. Relax your shoulders back and down. Stay in upright position. Relax your arms. Turn your palm facing up, just helping us to receive the energy from the Mother Earth, from the surrounding, and keep your eyes closed. And just observing our breathing. When we observe our breath, it's absolutely fine if sometimes our breathing becomes soft, slow, that's good. But if your breathing becomes shallow, becomes short, that is also okay. Just observe. And use your inner eyes to observe this body. No, I am sitting long, sitting tall. Lean back slightly so you can feel you keep your chest proud. Feel your sit bone, feel your buttock totally relax and make contact with this floor. Importantly, try to smile to yourself. Just a little smile on your face. Show the world how happy we are after we finish the session, after we finish doing yoga. Allow each and every yoga class to give yourself more and more positive energy. To give the energy to each and every part to your body. Sending the love, the happiness, the health to your legs, to your arms, to your body. Enjoy your hands, front of your chest in the prayer position. We're gonna end by saying the word Om together. 3 rounds. Say the word Om when you're exhaling with normal pitch. Om.